As we have discussed, acne vulgaris is a polymorphous disease. It can present with varied lesion at one particular point of time. The pathognomonic lesion is comedone. What is comedone? Because of hypercornification of the pilosebaceous gland opening, there is obstruction of the sebaceous gland outflow, leading to comedones. They are of two types, open comedone and closed comedone. The open comedone is the one where you can see a black dot at the opening of the pilosebaceous gland. Now, what is this black dot?
Here, there is a black dot. This is called as a black head or open comedone. And here, if you notice, you have multiple white heads or open comedones. Sorry, closed comedones.
Now, because of the oxygen content of the environment, the sebum gets oxidized into black color. And this is called as black head or open comedone. Similar to that, if the opening is not exposed, you will see a skin-colored raised lesion that is called as closed comedone. Now, in this patient, you can see it is mainly open comedones. Other than this, you have presence of papules. Can you see this lesion, this one? Now, this is a papule, which is a solid raised structure of less than 0.5 mm. And this is erythematous or red in color. This is also a characteristic feature of acne. If these papules are not taken care of, then it can progress to pustular lesion in a later stages. Now here you can see at this area also patient is having papular lesions and few pustules which is coming out.
The first very important point, that is presence of comedones. Now please remember, whenever you see a comedone, you should always say that it is acne vulgaris. But it doesn't mean that if the comedones are absent, it is not acne. So please remember this. Now second important point is presence of seborrhea. Now can you see the glistening shiny surface over the skin? This is because of excess of sebum secretion. And this is one of the causes of acne development. You can see that over the face, there are multiple lesions. You can see a pustule, you can see papular eruptions, and you can see closed comedones. So please remember, acne, it is a polymorphic condition which presents with more than one type of lesion at one particular point of time. Now can you see here there is little bit of exfoliation? Now this is because of the use of topical keratolytic agents like tretinoin as a therapy purpose. Now this patient is also on oral isotretinoin, which is a therapeutic drug for the treatment of acne. And the most common side effect of tretinoin or the oral isotretinoin is dryness of skin. So here also you can see there are dryness of skin, small flakes which are coming out, as well as oral isotretinoin, as well as topical tretinoin, which causes dryness as the most common side effect. And along with that, you can see that there are multiple papular eruptions with few of the closed comedones which are present here and there.
This is another case of acne vulgaris. Now here you can see you have mainly pustular lesions here. Here you have a papular lesion and you have associated post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Now please remember, if the lesion of acne is rubbed or manipulated, it can leave behind post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. In this female, she gives a history of rubbing the lesion, leading to this type of hyperpigmented macules. And if you look at this right hand side, there are multiple hyperpigmented macules, which are because of manipulation of the acne lesions.
Prep Clinic. Dream Beyond.